Hey guys, what's up? It's Teabag Swag here again, and today we're doing another Nightfall, but this one's a little bit different. Today I have with me a guest. Introduce yourself.
Hey, what's up guys? I'm Joey.
Yep, this is Joey the Bear Jew. He is in my clan, and he's also one of my best friends in real life. And today we're going to run through the Nightfall, and it is Panix the Scarred this week. If you played during House of Wolves, you'll remember that very much, because it was like every week. Anyway, the modifiers are Solar Burn, Airborne, Catapult, and Exposure. Exposure should be fun, but we'll go ahead and jump into it, and we'll see how we do.
I'm playing on like low sensitivity.
Oh. I almost sacrificed you to the curse roll there.
That's true friendship right there.
It is. Alright, well, I mean, speaking of new content, they kind of have some new stuff. I mean, sort of new stuff coming in December. I mean, it's really not new, but bringing a lot back in year one, but it's still exciting. I mean, it'll change the meta of trials and PvE a lot. New weapons and armor coming back from year one.
Yeah, most definitely. As long as they don't announce Thorn coming back, I'm fine.
Thorn, that'd be the worst, man. I'd probably have to stop playing Trials. Maybe Crucible altogether if they brought back Thorn again this early. That would be terrible. We'll get wrecked. Lexman will do so much damage.
Yeah, it really does.
Yeah, so anyway, there's an update coming in December. We don't know when yet. And they haven't announced the exact date, but we know it's coming in December. And it's going to be bringing not only these new exotics, but it's also going to be bringing... oh my gosh, that drag just wrecked me with the shrapnel launcher. Joey Hyde.
Don't touch me.
Yeah, anyway, not only the new exotics and armor, but it's also going to be bringing a lot of weapon changes. Weapon balancing and all sorts of stuff. Should be interesting.
Oh, no. No.
Oh, it's your boy coming in.
my gun isn't reloaded.
Oh, that solar burn, though. Watch out for that. I never even thought about that. His cannon is gonna do work.
Why don't we just kill him really good?
Yeah. I'm just gonna snipe him because of Black Spindle. Oh, and then, yeah, you can just pop Hammer of Soul. I mean, it's overpowered. So, go for it.
He's immune.
Okay. Yeah, he's immune. Can't take any. Ooh, wreck.
That's splash damage.
Yeah.
I
remember doing
the rock and it's going through the rock.
I remember in what was that? Prison of Elders when it was Solar Burn, you just hated it because Skolas would just destroy you with his Scorch Cannon.
But let's be honest here. We hated we hated Prison of Elders regardless of what it was.
I mean, Prison of Elders was good for a little while, but like after you played through it a few times, it was like, okay, why am I doing this? Because the rewards weren't that great. Like the weapons were good, but you never really got primaries at the end of Skolas. And
I did the first time we did Skolas, but after that it was just like crap tier rewards. We get a Fungi Sand that's gonna be top tier.
Yeah, I mean for it supposed to be the hardest thing in the game at that time, which I guess it was because you were 34s and you were doing a 35 activity. Like it just seemed like the rewards were a little bit lackluster, or they weren't even there at all. Anyway, I'm glad I didn't do my. I'm glad I didn't finish my Elder Cyphers until the next DLC came out, because I just got them for free. So that was nice. Oh my gosh, I'm jumping up top, man. I'm about to die.
Yeah, I was just up there.
Okay, I'm probably gonna die again. Yep, I died. Panic's just like had a laser on me, man. Yeah, here. Titan power. Watch your left. Oh my gosh. You're just gonna clap at me. Alright, bro. Alright. Yeah, watch you. Yeah, oh! You see, that's what you get, man. Do the slow clap to be sarcastic, man. Tanix will get you. That's how it works, man. Alright, so I don't know how. I don't know how. Hopefully, all the weapon balancing is good. They've been doing a good job of it lately, I feel like. They're gonna be.
Yeah.
They're gonna be buffing auto rifles again, which I think is needed.
Auto rifles aren't really viable at the moment. I mean, there's some that are good for PvP, but that's also PvP where weapons are. The damage is, like, kind of balanced.
Yeah, you can use the auto rifles in PvE. I mean, when I was doing the, what was it, Shield Brothers, I think last week, because Nightfall, I used the Supercell because that one's really good. I'm a big fan of Supercell, but I think other than that, you know, there's not really any auto rifles that are really usable in PvE. I mean, I think it's kind of a, just like a weapon type that you wouldn't normally go for.
When I say PvP, I'm not talking about competitive PvP. Because when it comes to competitive, I mean, all people really use is pulse rifles and hand cans at the moment.
Yeah, pulse rifles. And, you know, you'll see somebody with Hawk Moon. But normally, you know, that's really it. You know, you'll see people with Hawk Saws and Nerwin's Mercy, and that's really it. I mean, that's all you'll see. And, it'll be nice to, like, get something else in there that hopefully, you know, they can get you, like, some variety into both Trials and even the PvE game, because, you know, right now, like you said, it's just pulse rifles.
But from what I hear in the new update, they're going to be nerfing pulse rifles.
They are going to be nerfing pulse rifles, and the base damage of them, like the low rate of fire ones, they're going to be reducing the base damage by 9%, so guns like the Messenger and Spare Change, they're going to be nerfing their base damage by 9%, which is, that's a pretty good reduction. I mean, 10% damage reduction is basically what it is, and that's pretty hefty, you know?
That's huge.
Yeah.
Being that the Bad Juju was the weapon I picked up for more competitive multiplayer.
Yeah, whatever. And see, no big deal. I think it's Bad Juju is in the next one, I think. Not sure. They're in the next rate of fire class. No, they're actually in the high rate of fire. But Bad Juju is still getting an 8% damage reduction, which is, I mean, just 1% less than the high rate of fire. I mean, I find that really interesting. They're changing that so much. All pulse rifles are getting a huge reduction.
For no reason.
I mean,
oh sweet god.
Yeah, okay. It is for some reason, but I mean, but still, like, the reason itself isn't, like, I think maybe it might be a little bit too much, but I guess we'll find that out here in a little bit. And
yeah,
I'm like,
I mean,
one shot right now.
That's just me, I'm a pulse rifle fanboy. I ran through vanilla Destiny with a pulse rifle, so
gotcha.
It was always my preferred weapon, and then I realized also the scout rifle, because it's just an altogether better weapon.
Yeah, scout rifles are nice, for sure. And I think I probably have, like, in PvE, that was my most used weapon, is scout rifles.
It is now, since, what was it, Crota? Dark Below came out?
Well, even Vision of Confluence, man, like, that was just a gun. It was really good.
I never got it.
Oh.
Because apparently I'm some casual scrub, even though...
The salt. Salt is real.
Yeah,
well, I mean,
seriously,
you didn't really get into the game,
for
though.
The longest time.
Yeah, you didn't get into the game really until Dark Oil, though, right?
I played a little bit of vanilla, but... It... I don't know, there's something about it I just wasn't a fan of. Oh god,
with me. Yeah, and you know, the base game, a lot of people, they watch the Exploder sites. The base game that came out in vanilla, a lot of even like the most dedicated Destiny players could agree that it wasn't really the best. They had a lot of problems with it, and they stuck with it, and luckily, you know, Bungie has done a pretty good job of listening to the fans changing what needed to be changed, and it's turned into a pretty decent game. It's come a long way for sure.
No, I totally agree. It's definitely come a long way from where it was.
Yeah. And you know, I think part of that is they really do listen to all the player feedback, and they actually care. At least that's what I get out of it, because of how much they listen.
Absolutely. I mean, if Halo's if Halo's any example of like how much Bungie cares about their fans, then
yeah.
I mean, obviously they do care for their fans a lot.
Yeah, that is true. Dude, you're just putting in... I don't think I put a single bullet into that walker, even like soloing that thing.
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh, get away from me.
Oh, I thought I just killed myself with that trip mine.
Dude, I hate trip mines.
Yeah, I shouldn't be running trip mine right now. I don't know why I am. Oh well.
I have more deaths in PvP from trip mines than I do actual players.
Yeah, right.
From my own trip mines.
Yeah, yeah, my own trip. Exactly. Trip mines are deadly and not in the type you want to be, in the way you're thinking about. Oh, up rope.
Come on, I already.
There we go, I did my part. I finished him off. Alright, so I mean, you know, we've. There's so much in this weekly update, it's gonna be hard to get through it, for sure. But,
yeah.
you know, like the weapon changes, they're changing pretty much every single thing. Every single type of weapon, they're changing in some form or fashion. They're nerfing the pulse rifles, like you said. They're buffing auto rifles. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. That was close. Oh, we almost just both. He almost double killed MLG us right there.
Oh, man, I felt that. That hurt. Tanix,
chill out, bro.
God, your base cannon is just so powerful.
Yeah, they need to. Can we nerf the Scorch cannon, please?
Yeah, seriously. You know what I'd like to see is that as a heavy weapon, and not like you pick it up, but you can actually like use it as an exotic or something.
Dude, that'd be sick. Because I mean, you could use it in PvE. Obviously, you never could use it in Crucible. That'd be fun. Ooh, that rare Engram though. Dude, he just double meleeed us with that.
Yep.
Alright, well anyway, moving to the weapon changes again. They're nerfing the pulse rifles, they're buffing auto rifles. They're buffing hand cannons, just the accuracy when you aim down sight. So that's good. Because I know sometimes, like, when you're aiming with a hand cannon, your shot's right on their head, but really it's not. Kind of weird. Yeah, it'll be nice to maybe get a little bit more accuracy while you're aiming down sight with a precision weapon like a hand cannon. And shotguns. Yeah. Shotguns, man. They're still nerfing shotguns. They haven't figured out a way to do it yet. At least
right,
enough.
I'm gonna pop my my super real quick.
Show it, man, go for it. And you know the thing about the shotguns is they really have been, I think, just a little bit stronger than they should have been in, like, recent times. And, you know, year one, they were out of control. Like, they just had too much range. But I think now that they've, like, dialed it back a little bit, it's better. And there we go. Hey, a legendary. Ooh, the cloak. I got the cloak.
Notorious mercenary.
Nice.
Dead.
But now I think maybe this will be the update that finally
treasure from the queen.
Finally, like, I don't want to say fixes shotguns, well, but like brings them back in check, because they're nerfing like the damage falloff, like where it starts, and I think that's really like the only thing it needed, because you were still getting like sniped with the party crasher and like those types of shotguns, that archetype. And especially the conspiracy theory, like, that's definitely, like, my most hated shotgun. Oh, dem rewards. I mean, at least it's 305. Yours is 310, dude, nice. 310.
Yeah, that's...
Eggs. What's up?
Yeah, upgrade from my 294.
Oh, let's go.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude,
but on the other side, the shotguns are getting a buff to PvE, which was much needed.
Yeah, for sure, because, I mean, they killed them in the 2.0 update. I mean, it used to be you could just, like, almost one-shot, like, captain, you know, stuff like that, but now it takes, like, a good 2 to 3 shots, and...
Yeah, you have to put the shotgun, like, up their butt to even do damage.
Yeah, seriously, it's pretty bad, and it's nice to see they're sort of bringing that damage back to the PvE aspect. It'll be nice.
And, yeah, that would be really good.
Something I think that's been a long time coming is fusion rifle changes. Still, you rarely see them in Crucible, and if you see, especially in Trials, if you're just like inspecting what they have as their special weapon, and you see a fusion rifle, you're just like, okay, are these guys trolling? Like, what are they doing? And like, they're just not a good option right now. And I don't know if what they're doing is gonna change that, but I mean. It definitely is a step in the right direction. They're increasing the charge speed on the fast charging fusion rifles, and they're increasing the aiming down sight and crouch stability for all fusion rifles. And then they're also increasing the base damage against PvE enemies. So that's pretty good. Maybe you'll start to see more people using those fusion rifles in like strikes and, you know, stuff like that. No, Telesto,
I do
maybe.
Want to say though, dude, the Telesto. Let's just take a second to appreciate how beautiful the Telesto
dude,
is.
Dude, the Telesto is probably the best looking weapon in the game. It is absolutely beautiful. Like, it just looking at it is awesome. I love it.
Yes. Oh yeah, and any strike or nightfall with Voidburn, it's definitely a good option to use.
Oh yeah, you can just tear through enemies. I haven't used it that much, but I'm definitely looking forward to the damage increase and maybe being able to use it a little bit more. Sniper rifles.
Absolutely.
Yeah, the sniper rifles, they're they are still keeping the damage drop off, but the damage drop off is gonna start a little bit farther out, so it's still gonna reward you for your precision shots at range, because, you know, sniper rifles are supposed to have range like that, and it's just not gonna and it's not gonna be like in year one where, you know, you could literally be like on the one side of Widow's Court and then snipe a guy all the way on the other side of Widow's Court, and, you know, you're not have any damage drop off. There's still gonna be that, but there's it's just not gonna be as much, and it's not gonna start until you're a little bit farther out than right now.
Yeah, absolutely.
And one thing,
if you
I'm...
want, do you feel like?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sorry, keep interrupting you. Do you feel like switching characters and running it again?
Yeah, man, I'm down. Let's do it. Do it to Nightfall Run. I'm so down for that. Let me switch my weapons on. Package for Commander Zavala. Yeah, and so the Irene sniper, the Amawan Irene, I think it's RR4. Like, I know that is notorious. It was just kind of like, what are you doing, Bungie? You just took away Final Round, and now you add a sniper with basically, like, the same thing in there. Like, it doesn't... I really don't know what they were thinking
with
on that.
With a random Final Round.
Yeah, it's like, okay, we're going to take Final Round out, but we're going to give you back Final Round. You just don't know which one it is. Oh. But, anyway. Yeah, they're changing that to precision damage as well. So, no more body shots, sniper rifle, unless they're, you know, like, half health or three quarters health, something like that. Which is, it's nice. Yeah. I'm glad they fixed that so
much
quickly.
Much needed.
Definitely. And sidearms, they are changing the ready and stow speed for all sidearms. Which is cool, because, you know, it's basically like a handgun, and it should be quick.
It's a last resort weapon.
Yeah, and
I mean, if you're switching to that, you're obviously in trouble, so why not pull it out faster?
Yeah, and I mean, it's nice because, you know, say you're being rushed with a shotgun, you put, like, two bursts of your primary into them, or, you know, two shots with a Hawk Moon, or, you know, something like that, and they're just... You just need to finish them off, and they're, like, rushing you straight on with the shotgun. Switch to that real quick, and, you know, you just gun them down, and you finish off the kill. It'd be nice.
Ta-da.
Ta-da.
Everybody wins.
Yeah, basically what we're saying is, you know, screw shotguns. Everybody hates them. But, yeah.
I'm not saying that. I'd like to go on record and say I'm not saying that. Because I love shotguns. I still have my year one secret handshake.
Ah, yes. That was a good shotgun. I did like that one.
Yeah, it was a wonderful shotgun. What are you talking about?
Beautiful. But
I still had all the super overpowered perks on it too.
Oh yeah, it did, man. The rangefinder and all that. That
Hammer was, forged.
Yeah, it was nice. So in addition to all of the base weapon changes, they've also changed a lot of the exotics separately as well, because they needed a little bit more tuning. And that's nice too. I like that. I like all the changes that they're doing here. First off, the first curse and cannon, which is absolutely abysmal right now. I'm so glad they're changing. They are changing it to where the first curse perk now actually refills your magazine and provides better stability, better target acquisition, and the damage falloff starts further out while the perk remains active. That is really good, because I know in a lot of times when you use the first curse, by the time you get the kill and the first curse perk activates, you pretty much have to reload, or you switch a weapon and the perk deactivates. So that's really nice. Glad they changed that up.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then, you know, they're increasing the base range, and they're increasing the range to the imprecation, which is the weapon that you use to get the first curse. And they're also increasing the magazine size. So, all nice changes all around there. They're nerfing Hawk Moon a little bit, which is a bit surprising, I have to say. I think it was needed, but, I know there's so many people that aren't happy about it, for sure. Because Hawk Moon is still their baby.
Yeah, and all those new Xbox, all the Xbox players are finally getting a taste
what
the Hawkman
that's
is.
That's right, man. That's right. And well, the thing is, they never even got to really taste it in its prime.
In its prime.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that thing was just disgusting. You could, I mean, the chances that you can one-shot people were so low, but I think everybody that used Hawkmoon for a while has probably done it at least once, and you just have to sit there and laugh to yourself, because you're just like, dude, that guy's so mad. Like, that guy's pissed. Because you one-shot him. And it's just funny. But, yeah, it definitely, they're reducing the range of Hawk Moon. And they're also reducing the amount of damage the Luck in the Chamber and Holding Aces bullets do by just a little bit. So I think it'll still be able to two-shot people, but only from the up-close ranges.
Not from a mile away.
Yeah, I mean, because right now the range is still pretty good on it. You could still hit people from far away with it. But I think the damage or the range reduction is probably warranted.
Yeah, I mean, I've still been known to snipe people with Hawk Moon, but...
Yeah, I mean, Hawk Moon is still definitely, like, probably the best hand cannon. And now that, you know, first curse changes are coming in, maybe that might change a little bit. You might see more people.
Yeah, hopefully. Well, while we're on the topic of Year 1 weapons, let's just take a moment to talk about the Year 1 weapons that are coming back.
Yeah,
like, my all-time personal favorite, the No Land Beyond.
The No Land Beyond, dude. Yes. I know there's a lot of people happy about that. That is just, it's a fun gun to use. Even if you're not, like, the best with it, it's still, like, just fun. It's the satisfaction of hitting that headshot, getting the kill with it, and you know that, you know, they're going try hard over here. They're using, you know, pulse rifles and scout rifles and hand cannons, and you're sitting over there beating them with, you know, what's considered to be, like, a troll weapon. And it's just fun, man. And you know... It's, you know, obviously it's not always going to be the best choice, but it's actually a pretty good choice now. It's, you know, it can res snipe now, and it's just a fun overall weapon to use.
But, there's no greater feeling than making a whole team just rage quit because you're just annihilating them.
Yeah, man, like, if you get a whole team go in there with No Land Beyonds, and, you know, you're killing them, and you're pinning them back, and they're just raging, and then they just, you'll see at the bottom corner of their screen, you know, so-and-so has left the game. Oh, it's so funny. So satisfying.
Man, it's my favorite thing. Also, for Year 1 weapons, the Hard Light's coming back, as well as the Super Good Advice. We'll see the Plan C, Dragon's Breath, and the Mighta Multi-Tool.
Nice, man. And you know what's interesting is, because, you know, I know Dragon's Breath, people are just like, well, what the heck? But it'll be interesting to see, because, you know, they can make those little changes to it in Year 2.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be interesting to see. I know a lot of people, they thought that it was not the best rocket launcher. It's because it didn't have tracking, and the velocity of the rockets was so slow. Like, every time you tried to shoot somebody with it, it would just, like, they'd be gone by the time the rocket got there, because it was close. And maybe...
Well, on top of that, you gotta remember it was in competition with, the Hunger of Crota and, like, may it rest in peace, the Galahorn.
Yeah, I mean, there was no reason not to use the Galahorn, too, so that makes perfect sense. And, you know, maybe they will increase the velocity, or maybe they'll add something else in there that will just completely throw us off and be like, wow, this is actually a pretty usable rocket launcher now.
Tanix has been sent to plunder the hive. Your job.
So, and I know the Mighta Multi-Tool, like, there's a ton of people that just love that weapon. So, there I know there's an absolute, like, that is probably one of the most talked about weapons coming back. I know there's a ton of people that love it, so it'll be fun.
Yeah, and then with the buff to the fusion rifles, we'll see a return of the Plan C and PvP, unfortunately.
Yeah, and Plan C, even, I have to say, I mean, that was probably, like, the best option that there was, and it was still pretty good in Crucible, even after, like, all the nerfs that happened.
I would use the term best very loosely.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you were killed by a fusion rifle in Crucible, chances are it was either Plan C or the Pocket Infinity. And
yeah.
Just because those were the two best ones, you know? Out of all the fusion rifle choices,
cautious,
those were the best ones.
As you confront him.
Yeah, absolutely.
He will try to trick
there's also
you.
Some
fight.
year one armor coming back, isn't there?
Yeah, there is actually. We're gonna see the Bones of Ao. Hunters can rejoice.
Oh, nice.
Field distortion. Catch just
as well as the
Acleophage
Symbiote, which very, very good PvP. PvP armor.
Oh yeah, hands down. That was my favorite when I was running Gunslinger. I mean, you can't beat an extra golden gun bullet.
No, absolutely not. Right, we're also going to be seeing, for the Titans specifically, the Peregrine Greaves.
Oh,
which,
nice.
Not that great, but they're a lot of fun to use.
Oh, sure, man. Like, they're not going to be, like, your everyday use, like, choice for, you know, your exotics. Especially on a Titan when there's so many other, like, fun ones you can use. But, for sure, like, on Nightfalls or stuff like that where they has the brawler modifier. Oh man.
Oh yeah.
You can do so much damage with a single shoulder charge. It's crazy. Like, you can one shot shielded centurions and stuff like that.
Yeah, they'll be donezo. Also for the Titans, we're gonna be seeing the Armamentarium back.
The Armamentarium, yes. That is a fantastic weapon. Armor piece. I said weapon because, I mean, when you think about the triple grenades, that's basically like
Might
another
as well.
Weapon. Oh, wow. Thanks, Panix. Yeah, I mean, the double lightning grenades, double blinding grenades, double sticky grenades on either the Sunbreaker or the Defender. Even double suppressor grenades. I mean, think about in trials, you know, shutting down somebody with. Think about in trials the prospect of double suppressor grenades. If you know, you could shut down supers everywhere with Armamentarium. That'd be amazing.
Yeah. Then for the Warlock. We're going to be seeing the Apotheosis Veil, which I'm not too excited about. I think it's kind of a useless exotic now that we have all the raid exotics that have things like things like Infusion,
right.
Where they just come it comes naturally with
where your health regens when you pick up an orb, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Things like the Red Death. I mean, it's kind of. I don't think it looks good either, so, but that's just me. That is strictly my personal opinion. There may be a ton of other people that actually really do enjoy it.
Well, it,
We're also gonna be...
It regens your health when you pop your super, too, right?
I'm gonna be honest, I never used it, because...
Yeah.
I seriously thought
well,
it was a
I mean,
worthless exotic.
No, I agree with you. I never used it that much either, because when you had... Things like when you were doing Crota, that's what I think of because that's when I first got into it. I think it was a vanilla exotic though.
Not too sure, honestly.
Yeah, I don't know either actually because I played a little bit of vanilla, but then like you, I sort of got out of it and then I got really, really into it in Dark Below.
Dark Below was a nice change.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people think of it as something that was, compared to Vault of Glass, was really bad. But for somebody who, like me, I never even did Vault of Glass in Vanilla, because I got up to, like, I think it was, I got my Titan up to 25, and I didn't really know what to do after that, so I was like, well, I was really into Call of Duty at the time. And I was like, well, I'm just going to go back to playing Call of Duty, because there's actually, like, a... something I could work towards, you know, like getting all the camos, you know, that sort of stuff. But I didn't realize how good Vault of Glass was until I did the raid in Dark Below there. And I was like, man, Vault of Glass is amazing, like it's fun. And then I did Crota's End and I was like, man, the raid itself wasn't necessarily like the best one. In fact, I think a lot of people think it was one of the weakest, but
yeah.
Just the thing of doing another raid and just like how it was a switch up from everything I had ever known. And this is also my first MMO. I have never played an MMO before this game. And, even though it's like a hybrid, it's not like a true MMO. It's something different that I had never experienced before.
An MMO with training wheels.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, for people like me, you know, who have played World of Warcraft for a long time. I got into it during the Lich King, and actually stopped playing after a couple months after Cataclysm came out. You know, it's good because this is a first-person shooter, so you have that Call of Duty aspect that everyone's inner child likes.
Right.
But at the same time, you also have that. The questing and the grindiness of the MMOs.
Yeah, for sure. It's a good mixture, I think. But yeah. So the Armamentarium coming back is going to be a lot of fun for me, especially since my main is a Titan, and I just love the aspect of all the different things you can do with it, especially now that Sunbreakers are a thing.
Oh yeah, the all hail the mighty Sunbreaker.
Hey, listen, I don't care what you say, they're not OP.
Okay, that's exactly what most Sunbreakers say.
Listen, you as a main of a Warlock, you're just out here Nova bombing and self-resin all year one, and I'm just over here stuck. Which, I mean, Striker's good, don't get me wrong, but you know, Striker, Defender, you don't ever use Defender in Crucible unless you're like AE Gabriel or you're like this absolute beast, you know.
Well, I'm gonna be honest, I don't really use the Self as much anymore. Like, I'll use it for this because, one, it's Solar Burn.
Right.
But 90% of the time, I actually stick with Stormcaller because I think it's a way more fun class.
Oh, yeah. I love doing Stormcaller in Trials. It is really strong, man. Especially with that perk where you get the extended
landfall.
Length. Well, landfall, and you get the extended super length. Like, it's up for longer. Oh my gosh. Like, there was one time, last week in Firebase Delphi, I was like, hey, I'm going to pop my super, and I'm going to shut them down to get this revive. And so sure enough I did, and then the dude ran away, and I was like, alright, well, I'm just not going to waste the rest of my super, I'm just going to sit here in a corner. And I probably sat there for a good, like, 15 to 20 seconds, and then the dude ran all the way around the map and back into me, and I still supered him and got the kill. I was like, wow. Wow, this thing lasts forever.
It really does. Such a fun class. But on top of, you know, we're also seeing the Radiant Dance Machines come back for the Hunter, which, as someone who doesn't play a Hunter, I don't know too much about them.
Yeah. And for me, like, I actually never got an opportunity to get those. It's one of the only exotics I didn't get in year one. I'm actually excited to get the opportunity to get my hands on those.
Yeah, and then we're also going to see some new exotics, which I hear a lot of people are excited about. Stuff like the Twilight Garrison for the Titan.
Man, dude. Titan's Master Race after this, I'm telling you. Because, you know, Hunters, they have Shade Step now, and that's really good. But this is going to be, I don't know if you're going to say it's similar, or it's even comparable to Shade Step, but Titans, every Titan that I've known always jumps up in the air a lot, and you're gonna have the ability to like evade while you're in midair.
And Destiny player jumps in the air a lot.
And but I mean, especially Titans, the ability to evade while you're in midair is just gonna be crazy. I mean,
clutch.
I want to see how it works, because if it's like a thrust jump, like to the side or something like that, I think that could be really interesting. Just imagine, like, you're in midair and someone's shooting at you, and you use your evade, and, like, you just boost to the side a certain way, and you're able to get away from them shooting at you or something like that. It's just, it'd be really interesting to me. I'm excited to see how effective that is.
Then we're also going to see for the Hunter, the 18 ATS-8 Terra Antella. Apparently that's how it's pronounced.
Yeah.
It should be Tarantula.
Yeah.
Go with the spider theme.
But, well, I mean, Cameron, if you want to say Tarantula, go for it, man. I honestly don't know. That's just what I heard. It's Tarantella. Not really sure. It would make sense, Tarantula. That's when I first looked at it, that's what I thought. But, yeah. Apparently it's Tarantella. Which is, it sounds like it's going to be really good for the Hunter, the Blade Dancer specifically.
Specifically?
Yeah, specifically. But, yeah, it just looks like it'll be solid because your Arc Blade and your grenades recharge faster.
No small matter.
It'll be interesting to see, because most people in the Red Blade Dancer, a lot of them have been running the the Ahamkara Grasps or the what's it called? What's that helmet? I can't even think of it right now.
I don't play a Hunter, so.
Yeah. It basically makes your Arc Blade last longer.
Alright, let's see these rolls. Really?
Oh, dat shell. Oh, 20 strange coins. Them improved Nightfall rewards.
God, dude. 306 really?
Shell. Well, I mean.
Destiny.
Yeah, what were we talking about? The helmet or the. Yeah, I don't know if people are going to use it over the Mask of the Third Man, but...
Probably not.
But I mean, if you think about it, would you rather have an Arc Blade that lasts longer, or maybe the potential to get more in a Trials match? Because I know that perk on the Stormcaller, that when you're around your allies, it recharges your super faster. If it's like that, then you could potentially get 3 Arc Blades in one game if it goes to... Like 4-4.
Potentially, yeah.
If that's the case, man, then. And you have full, like, close to max intellect and max discipline, then your grenades will recharge faster, your super recharges even faster. Like, that might be kind of overpowered. You don't know.
Yeah, we might be seeing a nerf on that.
Yeah, I don't know. But I don't know if you would see a nerf on it, though, because you're specking for that. Like, that's the choice you're making, is to...
That's true.
You know? But, maybe if the recharge rate is, like, super quick, then yeah, maybe. Maybe they'll dial it back a little bit, but... You know, I couldn't see them nerfing it that much.
I already hate Hunters. That would just, like, put me over the top.
I know, and Blade Dancers, like, they're the worst. Yeah. Anyway, there's other changes to some exotics. You know, they're changing the Fabian strategy to... the perk is no longer buffing the rate of fire as a bonus modifier. It's now just straight increasing the rate of fire to the highest archetype of auto rifle. So whenever you get a kill with that gun, you'll have... a auto rifle that does the same damage but at a faster fire rate. So that'll be cool.
It won't be disappointing.
The black spindle, they're getting rid of the scope upgrades, so it'll only have one scope from now on, and it'll only have and you'll get barrel upgrades for it. So maybe, you know, increased range, increased handling, maybe, you know, on one of the options. You never know.
Which I'm gonna be honest about, I'm not too excited about, because I really, really like the different options of scopes for the spindle.
Yeah, and see the spindle, like, I'm a huge fan of the ambush scope, and I know people like the Hawkeye and people like the Taxus. They're all pretty good scopes, and to see which one they choose, I don't know, it'd be interesting. They're not like a ton different from each other, but there is those little subtle differences, and. To see which one they choose.
The subtle differences are what matter, though, to me, you know?
Well, for sure, and we know now from, I mean, I don't know if you've heard, but you know now that from, like, the Crucible sandbox lead, guy from Bungie, he talks about how important the range stat is. You know, it increases your aim assist and all that sort of stuff. It's interesting because, you know, if they put a scope on there that limits your aim assist, to what it potentially could be, you know. I know not a lot of people use Crucible, and it is definitely a PvE weapon all the way, but, you know, if it's harder to hit your targets.
Oh my god, dude.
What?
I just got another Crest of Alpha Loopy. Guardian, I don't suppose you... That's the third one today.
Dude, that's because there's almost no other chest pieces that are available. look at him. Look at him right now. He's so smug. He's just like his glowing yellow eyes right now. Yeah. Do you follow the Cryptarch on Twitter?
No,
he's like,
I
every
don't.
Time there's a chest piece available, the Engram, he's just always like, Alpha Loop eyes for everybody. His fingerprints are all over this guy. He's such a jerk. But anyway, the last weapon that they're changing is Sleeper Simulant, and they're increasing the inventory of the amount of ammo you can carry from 7 to 9, which is something that just makes sense because there's 3 in the clip, and you only have 7 ammo in there, so you have 2 clips and then one bullet. It doesn't really make much. They're
upgrading the magazine capacity is something that needs to be done.
Well, maybe in the future, I don't know, they might make a perk that,
we will test
you. Like, maybe it's an upgrade tree that you have to choose.
For those worthy.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Will you recognize strength?
But yeah, man. I think that's just about it, you know, they have, the last thing in the weekly update is the Refer a Friend quest that's going to be coming out soon. That basically, if you've been playing the game up until Monday, you are considered a veteran in the Destiny community. And if there's anybody that's getting the game in either Black Friday or any of the holiday sales coming up, then you can basically, if you have a friend doing that, you can help to Sherpa them through like the beginning content and like I'm assuming the raids and like all that sort of stuff to help them level up their character and increase their light level and just like help them out overall. Basically, you'll be getting some rewards for helping them. You know, I know they've already confirmed there's a emblem. I think there's a shader. There's a sparrow that you can get. So, I mean, it's cool that, you know, you were probably going to help your friend out anyway if you got the game. They're giving you some rewards for it. So that's cool.
Yeah, the shader is actually called the Infinite Link.
Okay.
You can actually, you can go look at it in your shader access.
And the emblem is the Sign of the Infinite, which looks pretty cool, man. Like, it's like a galaxy. It almost looks kind of like the director, like, where you choose where you go.
What's that under?
It's under collection 4, under promotional 5.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that looks pretty cool.
Yeah, it looks pretty cool. It's not something that's like, oh my gosh, but it's like, oh wow, that looks pretty sick. And you know, that way, you know, people you're helping Sherpa them.
Yeah, but let's be honest here. Who doesn't have Destiny at this point? Who already wanted it, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it's true. It's pretty, I guess, may not be well thought out. It would have been cool to have that quest around the time The Taken King came out. You know, like right as it came out, because I know a ton of people picked it up then. But, you know, I'm sure there are going to be people that have been playing The Taken King now that still have friends that aren't playing, and they're going to be like, hey, you need to get this game, it's really fun, and you know, they're gonna be having a sale on it.
Bro, I need you to get this game so I can get this sweet armor.
Yeah, bro, I need you to go spend $60 on a game. That way, I can get this really cool
emblem. Don't even worry about it. I'll buy it for you.
No, and that's completely the thing. Like, I know there are people that are probably going to buy it for their friends because either their friends can't afford it or they don't want to spend the money on it.
Dude, yeah. I might even just buy it for my girlfriend to make her an account.
Yeah, there you go, dude.
She'll never play it, but I'll play on her character, and there you go.
I wonder if you have to, like, complete the stuff together. I think that's how you have to do it, so.
Well, dude, you can play her account, and then I'll make another account on another friend.
We'll just share play it. We'll share play it.
Yeah. Yeah, dude.
Loopholes. There we go. Loopholes.
Yep.
That's funny, man. All right. Well, I think that's going to be an end to it. It's been, like, a really long video, but it's been a good one. Thanks for joining me, Joey. And
yeah, absolutely, man.
Got two Nightfalls in, and you know we're pros. Pros. Didn't
MLG.
Wipe a single time. I'm gonna edit out all of our deaths.
You didn't wipe, or I didn't wipe. No, I died once.
You know what? I'm gonna go back personally in this video, and every single time you died, I'm gonna like zoom in on it.
Wow.
No, I'm just kidding, man. Just kidding.
Wow.
Well, anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully you found the dual Nightfall a bit more entertaining than just me rambling the whole time. And I'm going to try to do it a little bit more often. So if you did like the video, please subscribe and like it. You know, and don't be afraid to leave some comments in there as well. And I hope you guys have a fantastic day and good luck in your future.